We just talked about the parent function for cubic functions, f of x equals x cubed. So I thought I should show you the graph of this function. Here it is, this blue, pretty curve. We can see that this has the same overall behavior as the other cubic function that we saw in the last example. That one looked a little more like this. But you can see that the overall behavior is the same. One end of the graph is going down to negative infinity, and the other end of the graph is going up to positive infinity. In the middle, there's sort of a gray area of, in this case, going down and then going up again, and in this case, sort of leveling out for a bit. Now, as I said in the last quiz, this parent function looks really different from the parent function for quadratic functions. Let's just add that onto our graph so we can compare them more easily. So here, once again, is the parent function for a quadratic function, f of x equals x squared. Let's examine the overall behavior of this graph as well. We know that the general shape of a parabola is kind of like a U, or if it's upside down, like an N. Whether it's opening upward or opening downward, a parabola has a vertex, which is either its minimum or its maximum, and then both of its ends point in the same direction. And then as x gets further away in either the negative direction or the positive direction, the graph points the same way. Either both ends of it go to positive infinity or both ends go to negative infinity. We also talked earlier about how a parabola has an axis of symmetry running down the middle of it, so that if you fold the graph in half along that line, it will exactly map to the other side of itself. That's not the case over here with x cubed. If we simply fold this graph in half down the y-axis, this right side is not going to end up looking just like the left side. It'll look more like this, not the same. This is all really interesting stuff. Now, since we're increasing powers, why don't we just do that one more time? So now I've put both y equals x squared and y equals x cubed on the same coordinate plane. And I've drawn another graph over here for you. My question for you now is, what function does this graph represent? Now think about what this graph does on either side of the y-axis, and also think about what points you would expect each of these functions to go through. Your choices are y equals x squared, y equals x cubed, y equals x to the fourth, and y equals x to the fifth. So you can always make a t-chart and plug in some points and see which of those t-charts best matches this graph.